Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for Summer 2015-16. It's now been 6 months since El Niño became firmly established in the Pacific Ocean. This is a good time to take stock of the impact so far, then look ahead at what may drive our climate over summer. El Niño locked in during May as Pacific Ocean temperatures approached 1 degree above average, raising the chances of a drier 2015. But very warm conditions in the Indian Ocean have been countering the worst of El Niño's impacts. As a result, while some areas were certainly dry, others had sporadic rainfall until August. And by September, a positive Indian Ocean dipole, similar to El Niño but in the Indian Ocean, had become established. The combination of El Niño and a positive Indian Ocean dipole provided a double whammy of drying influences for Australia. This meant the tap turned off, right at a critical time in the southern growing season. But late October and early November saw rain, up to a month's worth in 1 week in some places. While this rain was welcome, it hasn't broken the drought. Areas of long-term rainfall deficiency have expanded over the past several months and now affect every state. Some areas now need around 8 times as much rainfall as they've seen in the past month to lift them above drought thresholds. El Niño has also meant temperatures were above average over the last 6 months. October was the warmest on record for Australia. Victoria's maximum temperatures were nearly 6 degrees above normal, the most above average month for any state on record. With higher temperatures and evaporation, plus little rain, soils are now very much drier than average. Winter spring is the time when southern water storages normally refill, but dry and warm conditions have meant a very early end to the filling season. Inflows were very much below average, and many storages are now less than half full heading into summer. So what's driving Australia's climate? El Niño is still strengthening, with temperatures in the tropical Pacific comparable to the strongest El Niños on record. History and climate models suggest El Niño will peak by the end of the year. Of the 26 El Niños since 1900, only 3 have been followed by another El Niño the next year. 10 have flipped into La Niña and 13 have eased to neutral. Most of the stronger El Niños have seen some wetter periods near their end. This year's positive Indian Ocean dipole and its drying influence has already started to break down. In contrast, the subtropical Indian Ocean is expected to stay warm, feeding more moisture towards Australia. So what's the outlook for December to February? Rainfall is likely to be average to above average for most of the country, but a later start to the wet season rains is expected in the north and northwest. Our rainfall outlook has moderate accuracy at this time of year. The streamflow forecast for November to January shows low flows more likely at 106 of 108 locations. No sites have near median flows forecast, and only 2 are likely to have high flows. Accuracy for our streamflow forecast is high at this time of year. The temperature outlook for summer is for average to warmer than average days for most of Australia. Nights are also likely to be average to warmer than average across most of the country. Accuracy for this outlook is high at this time of year. After poor spring rains and early heat, the bushfire outlook has been updated. Areas of above normal bushfire potential have expanded in South Australia and Tasmania. So in summary, El Niño is expected to ease in early 2016. Odds favour average to above average summer rainfall for most of the country, but drier in the far north and northwest. Low stream flows are likely. The risk of bushfires is raised in an El Niño summer. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 17th of December. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Fakemer.